Listen for the words frantic and adorable. Becky Botsford, otherwise known as WordGirl, must face her greatest enemy in the world of family games, charades.
Waving your arms frantically. I know this, the Leaning Tower of Pisa. There's no way.
He's right.
Ugh.
Well played, Bob.
It's your turn, Smarty.
I know this. Rotten eggs. Rotten eggs.
Actually, Dad, Bob says he hasn't started yet.
Oh, my bad.
Uh-oh, an alarm. Bob also said he needs to walk around the city for a while to try to think of what he wants to do.
Bob sure said a lot with just one squeak.
That's monkey talk, Dad. Come on, Bob.
Bye, guys. Well, might as well do a little practicing on my own.
Across town, we see the reason behind the latest alarm bell, the master of meaty mayhem himself, the Butcher.
I thought I told you not to sound the alarm.
I goofed.
Whatever. Just fill this sackle with money, please.
Fill the what?
Sackle. You know, sackle.
Oh, you mean sack. Sack is another word for bag.
Yeah, great. What's another word for right now?
Immediately.
Oh, I didn't know that. Thank you.
Say, you look like a size 12, sir. Am I correct?
Yeah.
Well, we have the perfect shoes for you. Here, take a look.
Those are very nice, but it's not like I get invited to a lot of fancy parties. Then again, you never know. All right, put them in the bag.
You'd better be fitted for jail shoes instead, Butcher.
Word girl!
Huggy, let's take them down.
Two against one, huh? Well, not anymore, because now I've got a fuzzy helper, too. Meet the Meat Hook. I found him hanging outside Butcher headquarters. He was looking to join my gang. It was 4 a.m, see? And he was outside. He was all like, meow, meow. That's when I knew he was bad news. Bad news.
Can I pet him? Please, 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 can I pet him?
No, I don't ask to pet your sidekick. Meat Hook, let him have it with your venom claw. What are you, kitten? This thing is the meanest kitten in the whole world! Meat Hook! Tenderize him!
Oh, so cute!
This is embarrassing.
This little
teeny paw. While he's warming up, pastrami attack! Come on, Meat Hook! Hey, thanks for the shoes.
You're welcome.
Listen, Meat Hook. I know it was your first time out and all, but I have to say, I was expecting a little more from you. Why didn't you do to work, girl, what you did to the arms of my easy chair, huh? All you did was roll around and look cute. I don't know if I can take you out on any more missions until you're ready. Maybe you can answer the phone until then, I don't know. I mean, if I hadn't blasted them while they were all distracted by you... Hold on a second. When you did that, Worker wasn't paying any attention to me. She was powerless against you and your cuteness. That's your power. Meat Hook, you're a cuteness genius. And to think I was about to fire you. Meat Hook, it's time to give you a new name. Something that lets everyone know that you mean business. Something like Little Mittens. Oh, yeah. This town's about to get cutified.
Meanwhile, back at the Botsford house.
I don't know what to do, Bob. How do we defend ourselves against something so adorable? The frantic Declaration of Independence.
It's a movie.
Dad, you aren't supposed to talk.
Well, you aren't even paying attention. Every guess is frantic this or frantic that.
Well, you look so frantic. You know, frantic, moving around quickly, wild with excitement. Like this!
I look like that? Wow, I should act out something else before I hurt myself. What should I do? What should I do?
Uh-oh. While you're thinking about it, Dad, Bob wants to go for another walk to get ready for his next turn.
Oh, that Bob. Always prepared. Have fun, you guys.
Yeah! Look at the kitten.
It is so adorable.
Hey, does anyone have any string?
Why, yes.
Well, that was enough cuteness for today. Now back to work.
Say, don't we usually keep money in our bank?
Great job, little mittens! Now to escape before WordGirl shows up!
The word is escape, Butcher, and you're too late!
Am I WordGirl? Little mittens, feed him a slice of cutie pie!
I'm not looking! Captain Huggy Face, get him!
Nobody can resist the adorkable power of little mittens!
Adorkable? No. You mean adorable. It means really, really cute. Like what little mittens is doing right now. It's so adorable. Yes, you are.
The rubbish museum! Ta-ta, WordGirl. Come on, mitt.
Back at the butcher's lair, little mittens' reign of cuteness continues.
You did it, little mittens! You took care of WordGirl and a sidekick practically all by yourself! Who's a cute little criminal, huh? You are! Yes, you are!
You know, I'm sorry I doubted you, little guy. You had it in you all along.
Now let's celebrate!
On you not looking either. It's just so hard. It's like I have this cuteness sense that just goes off as soon as he's around. Hi, Dad. You okay? You seem a little frantic.
Why, sure I'm frantic. I raced home from shopping so we could finish our game.
Oh, great.
Funny thing. On my way home, I saw the cutest little kitten sitting in front of the jewelry store. Almost tripped over the little guy.
A kitten? What did it look like?
Well, was he ever adorable? He had one of those little paper hats that they wear in the butcher shop.
Let's go.
Becky? Bob? Hello? I'm alone.
Okay, now remember, stick to the plan. No unnecessary chances, you got it?
You are the cutest little thing.
Oh, yeah? Little mittens, stop, flop, and roll!
Oh, no! Not this time, Butcher! Come on, bring on the cute... Hey! Oh. Right, stay focused! You won't get me so easily this time, Butcher!
Fine by me. I'm itching for an old-fashioned throwdown.
Oh, hold on. Time out.
Time out? For real?
Yeah. There you go.
Daddy'll be right back, okay?
What? This is no place for a little kitty.
Okay.
Time in! Torque charger!
Monkey ball!
Salami slam!
Take this!
Mutton ball!
Ha! Missed! Coming back at you, Butcher!
Hold it! Hold it! Time out!
Time out?
Yeah, time out! I gotta check on... No! Little Mittens! Where'd she go?
Uh-oh.
Little Mittens! This isn't happening. This isn't happening!
It's okay. We'll find him.
I just want my Little Mittens back. He could be hurt. I have to find him.
Don't get so frantic.
I am not getting frantic!
Sound frantic to me.
Thanks. You're a big help. You know what? Hamalanche.
Hamalanche?
Little Mittens!
You're right, Huggy. We have to get out of here and find Little Mittens.
Oh, and stop the butcher.
A little later, and still no sign of that adorable little kitten, Little Mittens.
Little Mittens! Little Mittens! Oh, it's you. What do you want?
We just saw you down here frantically looking for Little Mittens. I thought we could help. Then we could finish battling and I could take you to jail.
I don't need your help. In fact, it's your fault that Little Mittens is gone.
My fault? Maybe if you didn't try to lead him into a life of crime, Little Mittens would still be around.
Hey, he came to me looking to join up, okay? He came to me. If you just let us get away, he wouldn't be lost right now. This is all your fault. Your fault.
Huggy, duck for cover.
Your...
Is this your kitty cat?
Little Mittens, where have you been? Are you hurt? Let me look at you! Where did you find him?
He was just down the street chasing a butterfly.
Thank you so much. Thank you. You're a naughty little kitty. Yes, you are. You scared the ham out of me. Don't you run away like that again, okay? Oh, little mitten.
I hate to break up this reunion, but we do have to take you to jail.
All right, Butcher. Come with us.
Little mitten! Little mitten!
Do you want me to take care of him while you're gone?
Really? You do that for me? Thank you. You got references, right?
And with the Butcher safely captured...
Make sure he has enough water! Spring water!
And with the Butcher...
On tap!
Aww. Aww, indeed. And so, WordGirl and Captain Huggyface have once again saved the day! This time from a frantic Butcher and an adorable kitty cat. Join us next time for another exciting installment of WordGirl...
I'm Bo Handsome, and this is...
May I Have a Word?
As usual, the player who correctly defines today's featured word will win a fabulous prize. Let's play!
May I Have a Word?
Yes, you may. Today's featured word is dazzling. To give you a clue, here are some clips from WordGirl that show the meaning of the word... Tommy, did you want to buzz in?
I was just thinking of all the examples of dazzling in WordGirl. There's the Hoboken Diamond, of course, and all the jewels in the jewelry store.
You sure seem to know what dazzling means. Why don't you just buzz?
Also, the eyes of WordGirl are dazzling.
Her eyes?
Yes. Do you dare to disagree?
Instead of answering that question, why don't you answer mine? How do you define dazzling?
Dazzling means bright, almost blinding.
That is correct. Congratulations, Tommy. You are today's winner. Huggy, show him what he's won. An official WordGirl Giant Disco Ball.
Ooh.
Yes, now you can boogie on down and feel the beat under the magic of a spinning light. A pretty dazzling prize, eh, Tommy?
Meeting WordGirl would be better.
Yeah. See you next time on...
May I Have a Word?
Listen for clarify and proceed. Just another typical day in our fair city. That's funny. I don't remember seeing that ominous-looking radio tower before.
Well, that's because it wasn't there before.
Oh, Mr. Big.
Soon, the city will be under my control. With a little help from... WordGirl! Leslie?
Yes, sir.
Put one of these on the side of every building in town.
Yes, sir.
It's time to start phase one.
Meanwhile, in the grocery store...
Relax. No grocery store would be complete without banana bonbons.
Excuse me, I'm looking for a tube of...
Okay. I'm sorry, what were you looking for?
I seek a cylindrical container full of mouth cleaner.
Cylindra who? Why, if it's cleaner you want, we've got tile cleaner, spot cleaner, chrome cleaner. Why, we've even got cleaner cleaner.
Negative. I require a cylindrical container filled with mouth cleaner.
Oh, containers! Well, we've got...
Excuse me, maybe I can help clarify. A cylindrical container is a tube, and mouth cleaner, that probably means toothpaste. So what your customer is looking for is a tube of toothpaste.
A tube of toothpaste? Well, why didn't you just say so?
I thought I just did.
There you go.
Oh, thanks.
Say, if it's cylindrical tubes you're looking for, how about some cheese? Or pudding? Or car wax? Or candy?
Yeah, a cylindrical container of mouth cleaner is an odd way to ask for a tube of toothpaste. It's nice when my vocabulary skills come in handy. Yeah, I guess I hear a hum. Well, it doesn't automatically mean something's going on. Sometimes a hum is just a hum.
Proceed with your automobile.
What? I have no idea what you want me to do!
Uh-oh, communication breakdown. This looks like a job for WordGirl. Word up!
One last time, proceed or you will be apprehended.
But how can I proceed when I don't know what proceed means?
Proceed means to go forward or continue doing something.
So I should just go?
Yep, continue driving. Proceed.
Word girl, you are a genius.
Oh, well, I don't know about that. Just clarifying another misunderstanding. That's odd. Sounds like another heated quarrel on the other side of the town. Yes, I hear the hum too, but... Uh-oh, that quarrel's getting out of control. Let's go! Word up!
Meanwhile, at the public swimming pool...
No. I instructed you to deposit the soil into the chasm across the pool.
Huh? All I heard was pool.
Word girl! Thank goodness.
Yeah, we got us a word-based misunderstanding here.
I'll do my best to clarify the situation.
What?
Clarify. You know, clear things up to help someone understand something.
Oh, now it's clear.
Your boss wanted you to dump the dirt into the chasm across the street from the pool. A chasm is a really big hole.
Oh, there it is. Thanks, Word Girl. You're really smart.
Well, let's just say I know a thing or two about vocabulary.
I can't understand you. Help, Word Girl.
Whoops. That's my cue. Come on, Huggy.
Hey, dirt pool!
Meanwhile, at an evil villain's penthouse apartment...
Yes! People are using big words all over the city. Confusion, chaos, and Word Girl swooping around, defining words and saving the day. Phase one is a success. Now on to phase two. Leslie?
Yes?
Have you finished placing all of the word suckers?
You mean the microphones?
Yep. No, well, those big things that suck all the words out of the air, you know. Word suckers.
Then yes.
It works!
Trousers is another word for pants. He wants to buy a pair of pants. Canine is another word for dog. She wants to know if she can pet your dog.
Word girl, I believe I speak for this entire collective assemblage when I say kudos to you.
Gotta go.
Ah, Word Girl, fare thee well.
TJ has a huge vocabulary? This is getting weird.
Back and forth like a little red ping pong ball.
Canine is another word for dog. She likes that kind of what exactly.
Phase two is a success. The city is in chaos, and the only thing that will save it will be my new product. Something brand new. Something... that no one has ever seen before.
I'm exhausted. Okay, I admit it. I'm having fun. I've never felt so needed in such a specific, word-centric kind of way. What? Whoa. What is that thing? The Word Sucker. Another fine product from... Mr. Big Incorporated. Come on, Huggy. It's time we paid Mr. Big a little visit.
Meanwhile, down at the loading docks...
Be careful with those, Leslie.
Yes, sir.
Those crates contain my latest and greatest invention. Don't you want to know what it is?
I already know, sir.
Right. Word girl!
Lose something, big guy?
My word sucker! That's private property, you know.
Were you recording all those definitions I gave to people?
Maybe.
But why? What are you up to?
Nothing. Oh, all right, I can't hold it any longer. I've been sabotaging the city with my big word mind control ray, then recording all of your definitions.
Why?
So I could create these.
Big boxes?
No. What's inside these big boxes?
What's inside those big boxes?
Well, I can't tell you that yet. That's for phase three. But I think you'll like them.
I wouldn't bet on it. I'm taking you down, Big.
Oh, come now. You've enjoyed every minute of this. Everyone confused by big words, begging you for help. The attention, the appreciation, the applause.
No. Well, maybe just a little.
I knew it. Admit it, Word Girl. Bigger is always better.
No, it's not. It's more important to use the right word than the biggest word.
Okay.
Come on, Huggy. Let's take him.
Not so fast. I just cranked up my big word machine to 11. Now the city is really going berserk. Everyone is using big words, and nobody can understand anyone else. Well, word girl, looks like you can stick around here and see what phase three is, or save the city by doing what you do best. What's it going to be?
Now, word up!
I thought so. Mwah! Mwah! Mwah!
Oh my gosh, we've got so much to clarify. To the concert. No. To the mall. No. To the freeway. Yes, I still hear the hum. You think that it's from Mr. Big's big word ray? I don't know. I mean, that hum could be coming from anywhere.
Actually, it's coming from a giant radio tower sitting right on top of Mr. Big's building.
Fine. You told me so. Seems kind of obvious now. Oh well. One big word mind control radio tower going down!
Not so fast, word girl! Ha ha! Gotcha!
Hey, what is this thing?
It's my hero sucker!
Let us go, Mr. Big!
No! Not until I tell you the end of my brilliant plan! I've waited all episode.
Fine. What is your big, big plan? I can't wait to hear it.
Okay, to recap.
Phase one, use mind control to make people say big words. Phase two, suck all the big words, with the definitions that you so helpfully provided, out of the air.
Oh, sneaky.
And now, phase three. I wrote down all those big words and their meanings and made them into a book. Now, the only thing that will save this city from falling into a big mess of big word confusion will be this, Mr. Big's Big Book of Big Words, a McMillions.
Wait, why are you laughing? I'm triumphant. I'm the only one who should be laughing.
So, you made a dictionary, did you?
I made a what now?
A dictionary. You know, a big book of words and their definitions. You've never heard of a dictionary?
Well, no. I took a lot of business classes in school. It never came up. Leslie! Did you know about this?
Of course, sir.
Why didn't you say something?
I thought you just really wanted to write a dictionary.
Hey, you mind if I destroy this radio tower now?
No, I don't care. Do what you want.
Want a piece of gum?
Oh, I'd love one, thanks.
Right on.
A whole big plan down the tubes. I tell you, this just isn't my day.
Well, it just might be my day because you're about to be incarcerated.
I'm sorry, could you...
clarify? Sure. That means you're going to jail, mister. Now, Huggy!
Should have seen that coming.
So once again, Word Girl and Captain Huggy Face save the city and clarify a whole bunch of words along the way. Join us again next time for another fabulous, miraculous, remarkable, and just plain good episode of Word Girl!
Hello, I'm Bo Handsome, and this is the bonus round of...
May I Have a Word?
Tommy, you correctly defined the word dazzling. Ready to play the bonus round?
I sure am.
Okay, take a look at these three pictures and tell me which one shows the definition of dazzling. Any guesses, Tommy?
Ha, that's easy. Number two. The butcher clearly thinks the shiny Hoboken diamond is dazzling.
That's correct, Tommy. You've won the bonus round. Huggy, show him his special prize. What? Oh, it looks like we ran out of prizes. That's embarrassing. We'll see you next time on...
May I Have a Word?
Favorite word, what's your favorite word?
I like the word dream because... when I think about dreams, it's something you want to achieve and a goal. And I want to be an actress, a dancer, and a singer when I grow up. And that's my dream, and I want to achieve that dream, so I really like dreams.
My favorite word is monkey. I am just a person who likes monkeys, and I just like the way the word sounds. Monkey. It just sounds good.
That's my favorite word.
It's time for another great moment in Word Girl Gadgetry with me, Professor James Doohickey. Today, gadgets gone wrong. When a gadget breaks or stops working properly, we say that it is suffering from a malfunction. Dr. Two Brains' Goop Ray malfunctioned. Dr. Two Brains' mousetrap for Word Girl malfunctioned. The good news is, Word Girl and Captain Huggy Face are both functioning properly. This has been another great moment in Word Girl Gadgetry.
Captain Huggy Face, show us what glum means. That's right! Glum means to feel sad. Congratulations, Huggy! Glum.